The first scientific method acronym I was ever taught was SHIOC. This was middle school. State the problem, hypothesis, experiment, observation, and conclusion. It seems pretty straightforward, and I didn't know it at the time, but that fourth one? That's a doozy. Contemplate this classic story. When a tree falls in the forest and no one is around, does it make a sound? It would seem so, but if no one can hear it, does it matter? What if I'm standing next to it? I'm watching it. What if I put a camera or a microphone nearby to try and capture that fall? Surely a falling tree makes sound, right? Yes, it probably does, but there's really no answer to this question. It's a thought experiment. It exists to illustrate a huge problem with science. The act of observation changes whatever you observe. Famous chimp researcher Jane Goodall lived among chimpanzee tribes for years, providing food and learning about their behavior. Her observation and her presence affected her results. And yet, what she learned taught us heaps about chimps and about ourselves. Does it matter that she affected them? Yes, it does. Did it affect the science? Yes, for sure. Did we still learn a lot abso-chimpin-lutely? We still do these chimp studies, even knowing that we're changing their behavior now. A new study found even if researchers stay away from the chimps, just knowing that they're being watched will change chimp hunting behavior. We're not saying that observation is negative. It's just out there. The act of doing it changes what you're observing. And we know this. In the 1920s, American factories wanted workers to be more efficient and productive. At one Hawthorne, Illinois factory, sociologists were testing different rest periods, some working hour changes, lighting and work areas. And every change that they made, workers got more productive. Even if they changed something and then changed it back, both things increased productivity. It turned out it wasn't the changes, but simply observing the workers changed their behavior. They felt someone was interested in their well-being, and that was enough. Sociologists have dubbed this the Hawthorne Effect, and it exists throughout science. In computer science, the problem with observation is called a Heisen bug. Basically, if a programmer tries to figure out where the bug is in their software, it won't show up because they're looking for it. In physics, they call this problem the observer effect, and it's super obvious because light is both a wave and made of photons, but depending on how you observe it, it will only behave as one or the other, which is really frustrating. And this might have you wondering, how can observation be part of science if the act of observation changes the results? Can we really know what a black hole, amoeba, or atom is doing when it's alone and unobserved? We can't. But NASA says on their website, the ideal observer is one who causes no unnecessary perturbations to the system being observed. Observation is a big deal, but less so if we know that there's an effect. In knowing that the observer effect exists, we can try to account for it. For example, researchers watching chimps have tried other methods where there are no humans around, like using drones. And, well, I'll just let you see what happened. The chimp prepared ahead of time and used a stick to take out the drone as it flew by. We changed its behavior even when we were trying not to. In the end, there is no do this and the observer effect goes away. Instead, scientists learn what the observer effect is for their discipline, and then they try and design experiments to minimize it. And that's why double-blind studies are important, and repeatability, and coming at problems from different angles. There are even studies of the observer effect inside of other studies. The SHIOC scientific method that I learned in middle school requires that we get information from the source to draw conclusions and then ask new questions. Even though some problems can be solved without ever going into the field, if we don't observe, how will we know? Special thanks to our sponsor, domain.com. When you buy a domain name from domain.com, you're taking the first steps in creating an identity and vision for your brand. No domain extension will help you tell your story like a .com or a .net domain name. Get 15% off domain.com's already affordable domain names and web hosting when you use the coupon code SEEKER at checkout. Observer effects also come into play if you could travel significant fractions of the speed of light. This handsome devil here has a video all about time dilation. Watch it, I think you'll like it. How do you guys think we could get around the observer effect? Take a crack at it, why not? Let us know down in the comments. Come tell me on Twitter @TraceDominguez or @Seeker. And subscribe for more videos.